Have you ever gotten in your car on a hot summer day? You start it up, turn on the AC, and hot air comes out. Well, today I'm going to show you how you can recharge your AC system. It only takes about 15-20 minutes at tops, and you'll get cold air coming back out. You only need a couple of things to do this job. I bought this recharge can of refrigerant in Walmart for $32. It came with the quick connect gauge. You need a pair of safety goggles and a pair of gloves. First thing you want to do is open the hood to your car. It's a good idea to do this AC recharge with a cold engine. The first thing you want to do is find the low pressure port on your car or truck. Most have the lettering on it. This has an L for low pressure. And just put that cap off to the side because you need that later. There's also a high pressure port, and this obviously has the H on it, so you want to connect it to the low pressure port. The nice thing about this quick connect gauge, it will only fit on the low pressure port, so even if you attempted to put it onto your high pressure port, it wouldn't fit. The next step is start the car or truck. Turn on your AC to the highest cold setting. Make sure it's on the coldest setting. And make sure the recirculation of the air is on. And let your engine run. Now what you want to do is look below your alternator. This is a 2004 Nissan Sentra, by the way. And you want to see if your compressor clutch is engaging, and mine is not. It normally cycles on and off when the air conditioning is on, but mine is not engaging at all. It's not spinning. Hopefully it's just that the AC needs more refrigerant. That's the reason why the compressor is not engaging. So we're going to add some refrigerant in a couple of minutes, and we'll see if that turns on. Next step is you want to see what the current temperature is outside wherever you're doing this job. For me right now, the temperature is 77 degrees. The nice thing about this refrigerant, if you peel the label back, has very clear and concise instructions on how to do this, so you could always refer back to this if you need to. And I suggest you read it first before you do it. Next, what you want to do is take your hose connector. You want to take the quick connect end of it, and we're going to attach it to the low pressure service port. Now, the way this is set up, this connector will only attach to the low service port. If you try to attach it to the high one, the high pressure service port, it won't attach, it won't fit. So all we're going to do is push down until it clicks. As a side note, if you look at your engine and you're trying to figure out where your compressor is, just follow the aluminum tubing from the low pressure port and just follow that down here, and that basically connects to your compressor. I don't know if you can see that. And then if you look to the front of your compressor where the belts are turning the pulleys, this is your air compressor clutch over here. And when the system's working correctly, that clutch will cycle on and off. As of right now, mine has not moved. Oops, mine has not moved. But that's hopefully just because there's no refrigerant in the system. Okay, with the quick connect end of the hose attached to the low port, we're going to look at our gauge. And as you can see, it's on zero, the black needle. So that means that there's basically no refrigerant in the system at all. You could look at the instructions. If the needle is up in the green area, that means you have the proper amount of refrigerant in your system. And if it's in the red area, there could be something wrong with your compressor. Now that we confirm that there's no refrigerant in the system, we're going to disconnect the hose from the low pressure port. You basically just pull up on this black piece on the quick connect and it'll come right off. Okay, the next step is to take our can of refrigerant and we're going to screw the gauge onto the refrigerant. So we're just going to screw this on. You got to apply a little bit of pressure to get it to connect. Just make sure you have a good seal. You don't want to over tighten it. Just make sure you have your safety goggles on, a pair of gloves. Our next step is we're going to take our quick connector and attach it to the low pressure port. When you're doing this, you want to keep the can straight up. So we're going to connect this now. Just push it down until it clicks. We're going to pull the trigger and rotate the can. And the AC compressor just came on. I just heard it click on and it's spinning. So that only took a couple of seconds for that to go on. So we're just going to rotate this again back and forth. Every 10 to 15 seconds, release the trigger. Give it a little shake while you're doing it. Then pull the trigger again. And we want to see if that needle rises at all. And it is, which is good. The compressor clutch is still spinning. So, in my car, there was basically no refrigerant left in the system. That's why the AC clutch was not engaging. And it's almost there. Now you just want to keep charging with the trigger. You don't have to have it all the way up in the green zone. You just want the black needle to be somewhere in the green zone. So I can feel the can is almost empty. I'm just going to use all the refrigerant that's in here. Now as you're pulling the trigger, the needle drops down to zero. But when you release the trigger, the gauge goes back up. So that's normal. And my can is just about empty. Yeah, my can is empty. I don't feel anything else left in there. So what we're going to do now is release the quick connect off the low pressure port. We're gonna put our cap back on. And then we're gonna go inside the vehicle cabin and check the AC and see if it's cold. Wow, what a difference. That's nice and cold. Amen. So over time, you're gonna have normal leakage of your refrigerant from your AC system. That's normal. You're gonna have leakage every year. I mean, it's minimal. This car is a 2004, so you're talking 14 years. All that refrigerant eventually came out of the system, so I had to put new refrigerant back in there. This stuff works great, as you can see. Just make sure, as you're doing this, you want to keep an eye on that AC clutch down here. Just as a safety note, if you're using this and when you're done, if you still have refrigerant left in the can, do not unscrew the gauge off the top because it's under pressure and you'll have refrigerant spray out and you could either burn your hands or get in your face and, you know, get in your eyes and cause damage. So if you have refrigerant left in the can, leave the gauge on the can. There's a point you might have to use it again anyway, so it's already there and it's already set up. Once you're done, just make sure that you clear everything out of the engine bay before you close your hood. I hope this video helped. Leave any comments below. Have a great day, and I'll see you on the next video, and don't forget to subscribe if you'd like. Thanks.